size 40 skinny jeans.
You didn't give me all that old hoochie nigga shit. Fuck it. Some leggings for the gym. Malaria.
Yeah, give me some fashion over flip-flops. Goddammit. Yeah, I'm gonna have a Mackish package pretty soon because we're waiting on the. We have a coffee table book called Ism Angels with Leyland Breed. So I'm gonna have a Mackish package and put all that stuff in there. What I feel about. Oh, yeah, the thing about Junior, the little fella man who got stabbed up in New York, that was horrible. That was horrible. That little boy got stabbed up by them niggas out there in was it the Bronx? Should I do that ratchet ass bullshit? And size 40 skinny jeans.
You didn't give me all that old hoochie nigga shit. Fuck it. Some leggings for the gym. Malaria.
Yeah, give me some fashion over flip flops. Goddammit. Yeah, I'm gonna have a Mackish package pretty soon because we're waiting on the. We have a coffee table book called Ism Angels with Leyland Breed. So I'm gonna have a Mackish package and put all that stuff in there. What I feel about. Oh, yeah, the thing about Junior, the little fella man who got stabbed up in New York, that was horrible. That was horrible. That little boy got stabbed up by them niggas out there was it the Bronx?
Yeah.
That's horrible. And now people are getting on the bodega that it happened outside of because they didn't do anything. The people who owned the shop, they just kind of stood around and let this little kid get stabbed. He's like 15, I think, right? And they let him get stabbed up like that over mistaken identity. And they caught all the dudes. My thing is, what makes y'all think y'all gonna go stab a motherfucker in public like that and not get caught? Mom, this is my problem. You niggas, when it comes to other people who are non-white, y'all are the most boldest, brazen niggas ever. Y'all go out here, y'all commit murders openly, you stab people in broad daylight, you stab them up in public. You're going to go to jail anyway, but you don't do shit about these white supremacists who are harming you. That's my problem. You dig? They were all Latino. Look, some of them motherfuckers was from the Dominican Republic. Those are Negroes there. I know they don't think they are Negroes, but they are. You dig? And me and Peanut were talking about this the other day. We were looking at 90 Day Fiance, and they got that the chick in Atlanta, the little cute ditzy chick. What is her name? She's married to Pedro. Pedro's from the Dominican Republic. And what's the girl's name who's dating Pedro on 90 Day Fiance? What's the girl's name? I can't think of her name. But some of y'all watch 90 Day Fiance. And Pedro, he can't stand her family because her family's kind of bougie. It's kind of that Jack and Jill bougie nigga shit. What's up, crazy cat? But Pedro from 90 Day Fiance, he was talking shit about his wife's family. It's Chantel, yeah, Chantel. That's her name, Chantel. Chantel, I know like her family, I know like her, so then this clashing because they think that Pedro's trying to finesse. I'm not trying to finesse, baby. I'm not trying to finesse. And Pedro was talking the other day, and he was like, her family don't like me. I think it's racism. Their job is to grab black people's struggle and then try to apply it to everybody else. This ain't, now the Supreme Court, they had the Dred Scott decision a couple hundred years ago. That's still the law of the land. This Muslim ban ain't even fucking close. Let's be very clear. This Muslim ban, you can't even compare that to the viciousness of the damn Dred Scott decision. The Dred Scott decision was issued on black people who were citizens, black people who were born and raised here, black people who built the fucking country. It said that black people here who built the damn country, you don't have the same rights as white people. You have no rights that white people are bound to respect. That's different from a motherfucker in another nation trying to get over here. That ain't the fucking same. That ain't the same at all. Motherfuckers ain't trying to lynch you. They ain't trying to Jim Crow you. They're like, you just got to stay in your own country. That's whatever. Is it based on race? Based on race. Based on race. What are you doing? You sleeping, man. That ain't the same at all. That is not the same at all. You better hold them nuts. They open up their liquor stores right in your area and be shitting on you. You understand? What's up, Bon Woke Video? They'll open up a liquor store right in your area and be whooping the shit out of you. You dig? I don't have no cape on, and I'm not sitting up here latching myself on to everybody else's struggle. Those days are done. Now that everybody else is getting a taste of the white supremacy backlash, now they want to come to the kumbaya with us. I ain't with that bullshit. I ain't with it. Y'all were perfectly fine with white supremacy when it was just us getting our asses smashed. I ain't marching with no fucking body. I'm not latching myself onto nobody, because there has not been ever any type of national or corporate backlash or outpouring or outreaching for black people getting murdered by these white supremacist race soldiers. There's never been that. So I'm treating them the same way they treat us. That's how I'm getting down. You don't see none of these people. There's not been no national march for black people being harmed by these race soldiers out here. You don't see the dominant society all having a big movement for us. You have black activists out here in the streets, but you don't see nothing on a corporate level. You don't see things on a media level where they're all getting together and saying, hey, killing all these black people is wrong. You never, ever, ever see it. None of these organizations do that. None of them. None of them. None of them. If they do, tell me when, where, when did they do it? It doesn't happen. But we're supposed to drop everything when these other groups are getting a piece of that damn Supreme Court white supremacy. Supreme Court, they've been on some white supremacy shit. It didn't just start with this ruling. They've always been on some white supremacy shit, but everybody was fine with it when it was just us. So you hold your own nuts like y'all made us hold our own nuts. I ain't marching with you. And fuck all that bullshit John Lewis and all of these other Sambo-ass niggas. These old sorry about that. Somebody's calling. I know. We're not going to the pool. We're not going to the pool. Somebody. I hate when people try to call me while I'm live. What's up, Jimmy Smooth? How you doing? Now I can't see you guys. You dig? They're gonna have to hold their own nuts, man. And the black folks, stop caping for them. You think that if you cape for them, they're going to somehow reciprocate, which they never do. They never do. They never reciprocate. You know, we jump out there and do all the fighting for them, and I see with this whole Muslim ban thing, all I see a bunch of black folks out there in the forefront. We're Captain Coon. We put our capes on and we think we're going to start caping for everybody. That shit is done. That shit is done. We're done with that. Those are niggas just trying to get some extra butter biscuits. Don't nobody give a shit about our struggle. They don't give a shit about what happens to us. And they're perfectly fine with all these white supremacists.
just fucking us up like that.